Okay, we're going to talk about correlation. So correlation is a connection between two pieces of data, but you can't say that it's cause and effect. So, for example, you could have things like eating certain foods, cancer, there might be a correlation, but it's not that you can say one thing causes the other. Warm weather and crime, your hours worked and the money you make, or the hours playing video games and test scores having a correlation. This one would be an example that it would show a negative correlation. Okay, does that make sense? That if one thing goes up and the other goes down, that would be a negative correlation. Okay, when you talk about a value, so if your R value is something like a 0.2, this would demonstrate low correlation. An R value, something like 0.9, would be a very high correlation. And then in the negative manner, if it was negative correlation, an R value of something like negative 0.3 would show low. And if your R value was negative 0.85, let's say, that would show high correlation. So closer to 1 or negative 1 means strong correlation. Okay, here's an example. We're going to learn how to calculate correlation, the R value. Okay, so the data I'm going to give you is the size of your house in 100 square feet and the price. So a 1500 foot house costs you 145,000. Okay, etc. I'm just going to fill in a chart for you. So 2400 square foot house would cost you $265,000. Okay, so if this data is given to you, in order to find R, the formula is fairly complicated and requires many things. So we're going to find them all in a chart before we plug them in. So the first thing we need to understand is the multiplication of the x times the y. Okay, so that would be going 15 times 145. So 2175. And then I will continue and fill in the rest of those values. Then we'll put x squared and y squared in the other charts. So x squared, I would need to write 15 squared. Okay, and that's how I find that, and I would fill in the rest for you here. Okay, and then how do you get the y squared column? You take the data in this column and square it. So 145 squared is 21025. Okay, and I will fill in the rest for you here. Make sure it's matching your data, your calculations. Okay, now in the next part of the formula, we need to make sure we understand the summation, what all of these columns add up to. So there's the symbol for summation. Okay, so this first column adds up to 165, 1334, 29611, 3855, 241, 394. Okay, so we have all the summation. All right, so let's talk about this formula. Okay, just below this, I'm just going to write x, y, x times y, x squared, and y squared. So we know which one's which. Okay, here's the formula. The R value is n times the summation of xy minus the summation of x times the summation of y over the square root of summation of x squared minus the summation of x squared. Okay, you notice how those are different? Summation of x squared and the summation of x, then squared. That value times, and then the same thing with y. So n, the summation of y squared minus the summation of y squared. Okay, so yes, it looks a little complicated just looking at it, but all the numbers are there and we're just going to plug them in. Okay. So n means how many pieces of data did we have? Okay, so looking in here, that is 8 sets of data. Okay, so I'm going to put in an 8. Now, the summation of x, y, so that's this number, 29, 6, 11, minus the summation of x, times the summation of y. Okay, divided by, okay, so now we're going to go fill in the bottom. So 8 is the n times the summation of x squared. Okay, so we got 3855 minus, and right here we have to do the summation of x, so that's this one, 165, and then square that. Okay, same thing with the y, n, 8 times the summation of y squared, so 241, 394, subtract the summation of y, so that's this, and squared. Alright, so we get the top to work out, 16,778, and the bottom, square root of 3615 times 15,1596, and the final decimal number is 0.717. Okay, so what does this mean? So that's talking about being close to 1. Does it show a correlation? Yes, it does show a correlation. So let's analyze our results on the chart. Okay, so in your book you have a table A6. So I'm going to go down to n equals 8. Okay, and we look to see if we're higher than this one. Are we higher than 0.834? No. Are we higher than right here, 0.707? Yes. So because we're higher than 0.707, we can say that there is a correlation to 95%. So we are 95% confident we can say there is a correlation or connection. We're not stating that one's causing the other, but we're saying that there is a connection. So that is how we're going to state that. And you notice that also looking at this chart a little bit more, obviously you don't take sample sizes less than 4. You're not working with good data if you're only taking a sample size of 2 or 3 and there's a connection, right? You're not really proving much. And as the n goes up, okay, as your number of samples goes up, your percents are lower because you have more data. You don't have to have as much of a correlation to show that there is correlation. Okay? And that's the R value.